Well, at least the minister is taking the main gate route today. Yesterday he was going through the back entrance of his own house to avoid Times Now cameras. With me in the studio is Majid Memon, National Secretary of the NCP and Senior Advocate. K.C. Tyagi, General Secretary and Spokesperson of the JDU. Satyapal Jain, National Head of the Legal Cell of the Bharatiya Janata Party. He is the one man, army against Pawan Kumar Bansal, been leading the charge on Pawan Kumar Bansal. Abid Rasool Khan of the Congress Party and Shazia Elmi of the Aam Aadmi Party. Should we go straight on the facts? Mr. Abid Rasool, I would like to go straight on fact because I know the rhetorical positions that both sides will take. So on Times Now, I want to go straight on the facts. Satyapal Jain, what is new about the facts you have presented today against Pawan Kumar Bansal? And do any of the facts you present directly implicate him? The Congress party says that all the material power Satyapal Jain is presenting, none of it directly implicates Pawan Kumar Bansal.
See, the first thing that I have clarified today is that when this fellow, his bhanja, was caught accepting bribe, he said, I have nothing to do with him. Today I have showed a CD in which his son, Amit Bansal, 6 years back had admitted that in our concern, we can print the price of rupees 150 even on a medicine which actually cost rupees 15. And when Mr. Bansal was confronted with that, the admission of his son, even then the comment was saying, I have nothing to do with my son. It is his natural routine that he disowns everything, maybe of his son, his family and all that. See, Mr. Arnab, let us put the facts straight. On 1st of May, the promotion of Mr. Mahesh Kumar is ordered by the Railway Minister. Before that, Mr. Mahesh Kumar complains to the CBI that he is not being promoted, somebody is demanding money. On 3rd of May, the Mahesh Kumar arranges to pay rupees 90 lakhs to Mr. Vijay Singla in the colony in Chandigarh, Sector 28A, where Mr. Bansal is also residing and Mr. Singla is also residing. The distance is about 100 or 150 meters. I am asking a basic question from Mr. Bansal and those who are supporting Mr. Bansal. As a railway minister, when it came to his notice around 10 p.m. on 3rd of night, he might have come to know of it earlier also, when it broke on the all television channels, why is Mr. Bansal hiding since then? As a railway minister, was it not his moral and legal duty to immediately find out what has happened, why somebody has given bribe? He is hiding. He switched off his mobile phone, all the telephone phone. 4 days have passed. Till date, the minister has not come out with the explanation except a four-line statement which was issued after 18 hours of the incident that...
No, so you are arguing on perception, Mr. Satyapal Jain. You didn't answer my question. My question was, what do you have which technically... You see, I spoke to a senior minister today. And what the senior minister says is that nothing...
Hello.
Mr. Satyapal Jain, can you hear me?
Yeah,
Mr. Jain, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Mr. Jain, a senior, very, very senior minister in the government of India, told me today that none of this directly implicates the rail minister himself. So what if his relatives are corrupt? So
I'm
what saying, if you point
yes,
out something
yes,
against his son
question.
Tomorrow?
I am replying to your question. Now the question is whether Mahesh Kumar made... It is a fact that he made a payment of 90 lakhs to Mr. Vijay Singla. His secretary, Rahul Bhandari, is now in the dock because of 40 talks within 2-3 days with Mr. Vijay Singla. Now the only question is whether this amount was paid to be paid to Mr. Bansal or not. Unless Mr. Bansal resigned, no official will come and depose against him.
Abid Rasool, why is the rail minister resigning? What about the new facts the BJP leader has brought out against his son?
Arnab, my first question.
One minute. I have not finished.
Okay.
I have not finished, Mr. Rasool.
Okay.
I have explosive new details as well. That there is a phone number. My sources are telling me that there is a phone number from Singla's phone 9872, it goes on, to another phone number 9650. Multiple calls from Singla's phone to a phone number which belongs to a senior official directly working under Mr. Pawan Kumar Bansal, which is now under the CBI scrutiny, and therefore that official will have to be called for interrogation. Like in Ashwini Kumar's case, by supporting him, you're getting into a big mess. You're getting into a big mess.
Enough.
Yes, Mr. Rasool,
yeah.
Would you like to reply?
Yes.
either to me or to Satyapal Jain directly.
No, no. Arnab, first of all, I would like to ask my friend Mr. Satyapal Jain whether he is satisfied with the CBI probe or not. Or have they decided to ask for some other probe, as it's a habit with them from time and time. If they are satisfied with the CBI probe going on, our party has made it very clear, time and again, from the highest authorities down to the spokesperson, down to me, that if anything is found out in the CBI's probe, we directly index Mr. Bansal. Definitely we will consider that and we will take suitable and appropriate action. So when the probe is going on, now let me complete.
You are buying time. Simply you are buying time. You are not answering my question.
Complete it.
No, no, you are buying time.
The whole debate of crux of the debate, the way you are presenting it, it rests on that even if there is no direct allegations or indictment, you want somebody to resign on moral grounds. If that is the case, this demand should not have come from BJP. This demand should not have come from BJP. It could have come from any other quarter. We would be happy to answer. But BJP, who is mired in controversy after controversy, who is mired in criminals being appointed as general secretaries, who is mired that the president of the party is removed.
Don't bring that argument.
No.
You're corrupt, I'm corrupt, we're all corrupt. None of us should point the finger at each other.
Quiet,
that argument does not hold.
My point here is...
Satyapal Jain is responding.
Yes, I like to respond to him. So far as CBI's registering of the case is concerned, it was registered because Mr. Mahesh Kumar had complained to the CBI before his promotion that somebody is demanding money and that is why he is not being promoted. The moment settlement was done, he withdrew his complaint. Then it were other players who came into the picture. I compliment the CBI for registering the case, for arresting these four or five persons. But we are surprised. Not only as a BJP worker, as a practicing advocate, when the promotion has been made by the railway minister, the payment has been made to his nephew, it is his private secretary who is going to be interrogated.
Why don't you have patience? Why don't you have patience? And why are you coming onto the streets and trying to do
it? You are giving an investigation, Suresh Kalmadi, when he was asked to go. Was the CBI not investigating A. Raja when he was asked to go? Were any of those investigations over? Were the investigations against Dayanidhi Maran over in the SL Maxis deal? Why in this particular case are you applying a different logic? My next question goes to Shazia LB. Shazia, no. And you haven't answered my question as to why, when if Singla has nothing to do with the functioning of Pawan Kumar Bansal as rail minister, then why was he in touch with an official of the railway ministry?
And he was present with Mr.
Shazia LB, do you buy the Congress?
All the points you are raising are in consideration of the CBI.
Party's point of view.
Well, first of all, we've also asked for the resignation of Pawan Kumar. Now, there are two questions. Will the Railways Minister resign? And should he resign? And we all know the answer to that. He should resign. It's only morally proper to do so. Not just that, if you look at things technically and even legally, now there is an arrest that has been made. Why was the nephew paid and the sum of 10 crores, 90 lakhs first to start with, for a job, which is an important job, railway board membership, electrical, which is responsible for tenders and contracts worth 50,000 signaling contracts, which is a huge amount. So it's a lucrative ministry, we all know. The second question is, can the railway ministry, which is a very big ministry, and this is beyond Congress and BJP, because the nation does not belong to the Congress or the BJP, it belongs to the people. And I want to ask, how can the railway minister treat it as his personal fiefdom and allow his nephews to make such, to take bribes, accept bribes, deal with all the officials, and be part of
nothing,
all the dealing
nothing
that is required, and affect transfers and promotions in that department.
The way you are trying to project that you are the people of India, I don't agree with you. People of India.
So the Railway Minister should resign immediately. This is an act of the brazenness beyond redemption, no. I would say. This is brazenness beyond redemption.
Logically. No, let's look at it very logically. One minute. Let's divorce this from emotions and ask a pretty straightforward question. I would like to ask Majid Mehman, who wears two hats. I first want to ask you, sir, you wear a hat as a senior advocate and you wear a hat as an NCP leader. Will you be willing to wear your hat as an NCP leader and answer my first question?
You see, let me tell you, Arnab, that we will have to first examine it from legal point of view, then political.
Okay, so from the legal point of view, my question to you is this.
See, the crime investigation is a very important fact which we must take note of. And you know, when a man commits crime, his father, his son or his nephew is not hanged for the crime
committed. So you are defending
man. No, I am not defending. Now see, but then the man whose relative commits a crime, whether it is whether it's an offence under Prevention of Corruption Act, whether it's an offence of cheating or whatever it is, in that event, if that man is also indirectly contributing to that crime or is somehow involved in that crime, so, then you have to collect.
So prima facie, in this case, my question to you is, the fact is the money has exchanged hands for a post in the Indian Railways, right? Taking it further from there, the money has to reach the right person.
No, it's not the money.
No, the money has to reach somebody who is in a position to influence the decision.
No, you are not. You see, give me a minute. I will just explain.
Fine.
I'll just take 1 minute more. See, here the Navy is alleged to have resorted to some activity which is an offence of offering or selling a job. Now, whether the minister himself has anything to do with it or not is a $1 million question.
No, but my question is very simple.
Yes.
My question was, taking it further from there, Majid Memon, the money has to reach the right person who is in a position to make/influence a decision, going by this simple logic.